Hello everyone and welcome to Bannerman. Bannerman is an upcoming real-time strategy game. It was originally kickstarted, but the Kickstarter campaign was cancelled. But the developers did release this pre-alpha demo here, and we're going to play that. It contains just one mission, but it's kind of nice they did release it nevertheless, so something came out of the campaign. So I've got my select units here. This game is a traditional medieval real-time strategy game. It does feature base building, it does have, or at least it is planned to have, a single-player campaign, a multiplayer mode, skirmish mode, and all those nice things. And we are going to check it out. So Lord Barian here is apparently going to guide us through the tutorial, and going to have our foot soldiers move, so we'll briefly move over to this marker here. So far the game runs pretty stable. The frame rate is decent, and it looks decent. It doesn't look totally top-notch, but I don't really expect that, and to be honest, I don't really need that. As long as it does look pleasant, I'm generally happy. Look at that. You have discovered the main base and some workers. Workers are only units, are the only unit that can construct buildings and collect resources. There are two types of resources in Bannerman, wood and gold. Okay, so we do have those classic resources, essentially the ones we had in the original Warcraft. And we're going to do some hunting and gathering, or maybe gathering, I suppose. So let's select some of our workers, and you can gold mine a little bit. And you guys, please collect me some wood. Do we have groups? We do have groups indeed. That is always useful. And let's see how we actually, how much we actually need to construct a house. So build menu, main base. House cost me 50 wood, which I should have in a moment. So yeah, once this guy here comes back, there we go. So you construct me a house. Here we have our main base, or HQ. Main base is a little bit of an odd name for that, but I guess I can always change that later. Can we zoom? We can zoom, and it's this zoom here that gets you into this Fox third person. Well, it is a third person perspective, obviously, because it's not first person, but you know what I mean. It kind of looks like the over the shoulder perspective, which I kind of get. It looks a little bit more interesting. Occasionally it's nice to zoom in and see battle up close like this, but at the same time I would prefer to be able to move out a little bit more. But never mind. So we want to produce an army, and we need a training camp for that. So let's see how expensive that is. 100 wood, and also a bunch of gold, but we do have enough gold, so we don't really need that all that desperately. So you can please collect me some more here. And this is a lumber mill. Okay, so we get stuff from the lumber mill, so this is essentially like a wood mine. I guess that makes sense. I guess the positive side effect here is that we don't have to chop down all the trees, and the map doesn't look like an environmental disaster once we're done here. And oh no, there's this lock here. We just can't continue. It's just too much of an obstacle. So I think we have enough now. We do indeed, but we don't want a blacksmith. I guess a blacksmith for upgrades. At least that will be the blacksmith's traditional use. This game seems to be quite traditional for the most part, but I don't really mind that, because we didn't really have that many games that followed the 90s RTS formula in recent times, and I'm generally happy with these games, especially if the single player campaign is nice. So I should recruit two archers, which cost me a lot of wood and some gold. So let's do just that, and let's get some wood. In fact, one of you can help these guys here gather some wood, because we have plenty of gold, and it seems like, yeah, wood is kind of, it almost seems like wood is the more important resource, at least right now. Usually it's gold that's kind of the universal research, and wood is the ones you need for buildings and upgrades and stuff like that, and some units that have like a bow like this, but I'm not going to complain. You've got some target dummies, which looks nice as well. And did I even, oh okay, so can I, so I can queue up units, but only a couple of them. Well, still better than the original Age of Empires, I presume. So let's see what we do next. Okay. Alright, so we're going to do some army practice. I can do that. Let's see what's going to await us here. Wild enemies probably, or target dummies. I suppose that's fair too. So everybody gang up on this guy here. And you shoot these practice dummies here, which get destroyed in the practice. So those are some vicious arrows we're shooting. And next is going to be another task here. So this is very much like a tutorial section, but I think it's not a bad thing because it does mean you get a feeling for what the game expects you to do. And maybe this is even the intended tutorial mission just released as a demo now. So, oh, okay, that looks interesting. All right, let's fire on here now, which I don't seem to be able to do with a right click. I guess we have to, oh, there we go. So we have to force fire on that. Okay, so I was feeling there's an enemy base nearby. What a shocking revelation. This looked a little bit odd. Well, I probably shouldn't put my artillery up front, but I guess it's not that important. Yeah, this looked a little bit odd, but I like the effects. It's kind of nice to have effects like that. It kind of reminds me of the dam in Command & Conquer Generals, where you could destroy the dam, that would flood an area, would open up new areas and make others impassable. That was kind of nice. And they also used it in every campaign because they were really proud of that, I think. So, looks like I've got an enemy base here. So let's blow that up, but it doesn't seem to be the end of the mission because there's still other areas left. So I suppose there's more to do. And this is an altar, maybe? Who knows? We'll find out soon. For now, let's just demolish other people's property. I wonder whether we can take over units in this game here. If this does take some inspiration from Age of Empires, maybe there's priest units who can do that. We shall find out. Or did I not include you in that group? I evidently did not, which is fine. But I guess I'm... Okay, you don't seem to be able to... Do I have to use force fire? It seems like it. Okay, that's a bit odd, but well, I guess don't need you anymore now. So now it's time to head south, east, and visit the Barion Castle. To do that, you need to cross the lake. So let's check out whether this does anything. It does not seem to do anything, and I don't seem to be able to collect it, but that's okay. Oh dear, so how do we do that? The lake must be frozen so that your army can move across it. To freeze the lake, you need to take control of nature powers. To control of the nature power, you have to build a temple on a holy spot. Okay, I can do just that. So let's take one of your workers here and build a temple. So this brings in some supernatural elements, which you may or may not like, but I think it doesn't really hurt. And that apparently gives us some sort of... I'm going to call it general's power for now, or support power, whatever you want to call it. And here's a temple. Yeah, I will admit the buildings don't look super distinct. I think they kept them quote-unquote realistic. But then again, keep in mind that this is... Where's my base? Nope, no home button. Keep in mind that this is... Did I actually send a worker over here? Yeah, I did, so there we go. Keep in mind that this is still a pre-alpha demo, so the final game is going to look a little bit different. Now, regarding the Kickstarter campaign, which was initiated by this team here, which is a Swedish team, or at least it's based in Sweden, there were some technical issues, and there were a lot of credit cards that were declined, so many in fact that the Kickstarter's budget dropped by half over the course of a day. So that it had to be some technical issue. I can't imagine that by coincidence so many people just happen to have bad credit card data. And they did cancel the campaign, unfortunately, which I think was a little bit premature, but it's their decision ultimately. But I think they said that they would still continue to work on the game, so we'll see. Anyway, we now have the... Okay. Okay, so that's a general power. I thought I had to target that. And that's kind of interesting. This is a... That's an interesting thing. If they manage to integrate this properly and don't make it too situational, this is going to be a very nice feature indeed. And there we go, you're dead. Like death animations, those are always important. Killing your enemies should be satisfying. And yeah, it really seems like the catapult has to be auto. Well, not auto-aimed, it has to be aimed manually. But yeah, it's not too much of a problem. And there we go, victory indeed. Thanks for playing the very first demo of Bannerman. You're welcome. So yeah, I'm going to give you a link to the demo in the description as well to the developer's website. I think so far this game is fairly basic. It doesn't really hold all that many surprises, but I don't think that's necessarily a bad thing. And yeah, I think I might try out some of the additional buildings, but we'll see. Thanks for watching, and see you then.